Oh, happy day, beautiful people. Welcome to another Pause Reset Unplugged. And I'm your host, Natalie Francis-Clarke. Let me tell you something. It is such a beautiful day. I don't know if you can see the sun shining in, but it feels so good, right? So, since the last time, yes, Pause Reset Brunch 2024, Reclaiming Your Crown, happened. It was a beautiful event. So before I even go any further, thank you, Lisa Carter. Thank you, Latoya Hill. Thank you, Tori Stevens. Thank you, of course, Otissa Marble, and to my new board. Ooh, we have myself. We have Otissa Marble, of course. We have Chawana Golden. We have Francis Zamora. And we have Shamar Clark. So like I said, stay tuned for more things to come. Just wanted to put that out there. But the event, like I said, was beautiful. It was wonderful. Shout out to Verna, who was helping out in the front registration. So thank you. Thank you, Verna, for helping out. So, Hannah, today we have Victor Callender. Guess what? Today is actually my first guest on Pause Reset Unplugged. That's right, my first guest. I'm so excited. You know, so Victor, you know, I'll let him tell you everything, but he is actually having his very first art show on April 4th, 2024 at the Long Room, which is located 1111 Central Avenue in the Plaza Midwood area, right? So I'm always excited when I see folks taking the leap and betting on themselves, especially when they're dope, you know what I'm saying? Especially when the you know, they're good at what they do, right? So, Oh, yes, because, you know, I always have something to say about myself, right? So, Hannah, my clothes are not fitting, and it's been a mental challenge to get myself right, right? I'll start off well, and then I'll fall off for some whatever reason. Just discipline. But I asked Tissa Marble of Keeping It Tight Fitness over the summer. And of course, she said, nah, you can do it. You just need to do this. You need to do this. Okay. Come on, sis, please. You know, this was me after the brunch because I'm just comparing pictures. Like, seriously, Nat? It's life, you know? But she looked at me. She said, you have to do the work. Hear me. Yes, I won't waste your time. I think those were the magic, convincing words. So thank you, Tiss. Thank you. Believe it or not, that is actually one of my motivations. One of the things that she told me to do, write up my motivations. So I have it on my fridge and in my car. Yeah. Don't waste this time. And trust me, I already know I'll be rolling my eyes at her during the workouts because she's already prepping me. And in the preparations, it's, you know, no carbs, no flours, no sugar, no sweetness. That's including honey, maple syrup. I don't use stevia and anything like that, but still, it will be none of that for me. She told me to walk outside versus, because the last 2 weeks I was walking in the mall or going on, you know, in the gym on the treadmill. And she said, do outside. So, you know, my neighborhood is mad hilly, Father God. Hills. Sometimes it don't even seem like anything but hills. So, this is my prep until our first workout. And I see, you know, she wants me to build my endurance. See what she's setting me up for. I'm not wasting her time. Anyway, and it just goes back. I have to go back to what I was doing for the last however years. I started my weight loss journey 2015, and it's been steady, and it's been maintained. And life after the surgery just did a number. So hey, I'm giving myself grace while I'm reclaiming my crown. Which is more of a mental thing for me. But these last days I've been walking outside and breathing in fresh air. And as she said, I want you to feel the elements. Oh my God, thank you. I've been disciplined before, like I said, but around it's just been harder this time around. But the angle is definitely worth it, right? It's all about me reclaiming my crown, getting back to moi. By the way, at the brunch, crown brooches were given to women in a crowd as a reminder to reclaim your crown, know your self-worth. Don't let nobody talk to you like you're a mad woman. Don't let no one talk to you like you're crazy. Know your worth. Release negative thoughts, all of that. Whatever you need to do to make you reclaim your crown or maintain it. Hey, it's all good, right? So just wanted to just give that little tidbit. I'm feeling good. I'm feeling good at it. Like I said, maybe it's that sun. Yesterday, I will admit, I did not want to walk at all. It was a rough day. I wanted Starbucks. I didn't want to walk. However, I just had some herbal tea. And I went outside, and as I was pulling up, walking up to the steps, I felt so good, and I was so glad I did it. So anyway, we will take this pause right here, and when we get back, we'll have Victor Callender on with us to tell us more about his art and this upcoming art show. All right, see you soon.
Queen of Bacchanal, I die on the road. I'm so devoted, yeah, I swear that I am. Maybe I should explain how I feel. Then you'd realize my love is real. Nothing else could ever come between, I swear.
Stage. When you give me the stage. When you give me the stage. 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 Yeah, I'm devoted. Yeah, devotion.
Well, as promised, first of all, welcome back from the break. But as promised, I have none other than Victor Callender. He's an engineer by day, also known as DJ Cali. He produces Papa Gray, which is a serious rum punch, but that's a whole nother topic. But today we are learning about Victor Callender, the artist, and the upcoming art show that he has soon, April 4th. So without any delay, welcome, Victor. Welcome. In fact, you are actually the first guest on Pause Reset Unplugged, not to be confused with Pause Reset Brunch Podcast, but you are the very first guest. So welcome. So let's not even delay. Tell us who Victor Callender, the artist, is.
Well, Natalie, thank you for having me, first of all. I am honored and pleased to be a part of this Pause Reset podcast. With me, I'm from Barbados, as everybody knows. I'm an islander. I moved to New York several years ago. Probably about 30 something years. And I was always an artist back in Barbados. Actually, I did a lot of landscapes, in Barbados, and actually did was commissioned by the Marriott St. Lawrence Castle at one point to do scenery on the beach for them, for their models, to pretend that they were actually painting the beach. And that was actually sent out as an advertisement. But that was when I was like in my teenage years. And I was also involved in an art foundation there as well, Pelican Village, where I had some of my pieces. But then, moving to the US and stuff, I kind of let it go for a minute. But I hooked up with a contractor in Manhattan who was actually in the Soho district, and he was also an artist. And just watching him do his abstract pieces and stuff kind of inspired me to start back my own painting. And I started back doing some painting and stuff then. Fast forward, I moved here to Charlotte, North Carolina. And, after a while, a couple of years, 2020, COVID hit, and country was shut down. I was kind of bored of my mind. And I had to find something to do. So me being a thinker all the time and always can't sit still.
You froze up a little bit. You froze up a little bit, Victor. So let's, you said you moved to Charlotte back in 2020. Boom.
Yeah, I moved to Charlotte. And then fast forward to 2020, COVID hit. Shut the country down. And I was bored out of my mind. So me being a thinker, I had to do something. So I just start researching and stuff like that. And I got back into art more. I got started doing abstract work. I started doing pendulums, actually, which is part of like engineering in me. But it was a little too boring, I would say, like monotonous. Mm-hmm. So I had to start doing something different. And I started, doing a little bit of the spin art, doing creative pieces with drills and stuff. So finally, I said, let me start doing some pour art, and I started doing some pouring and stuff. And that was kind of cool, watching colors mix together and the outcome. So I finally decided to, you know what? I'm going to get something built. So I decided to have a contraption built out of my daughter's old college bicycle. And, modified a little bit over the years, And this is, as you can see, this is one of the pieces that I recently did. It's a set of cornhole boards for a company. And then you can see some of the pieces in the back as well that I've done. So Natalie, you can take it over from there.
Okay, well, thank you. I know Victor is the person who does not like to talk about himself, but that's okay. So now, fast forward, April 4th is a big day. You're yes. doing your art show at the Long Room at 1111 Central Avenue right here in Charlotte, North Carolina. So for someone who doesn't like to talk about themselves, you know, tell us what to expect in the art show. Are these some of the pieces you have in the background? Will those be on display? And, you know, just tell us more of what to expect on that day.
Yeah. So the show is on April 4th. It starts at 6 o'clock. It's 6 to 9. Mm-hmm. It will be at the Long Room, like Natalie says. Some of the pieces that behind me will be on display, and there will be more, of course. I'll kind of do like a little black and white series. I started a little black and white series with Black History Month. So I started doing a couple of those pieces, maybe like three or four of those pieces be on display. Mm. Have some of the bigger pieces that you see behind me that will be on display. The setting is pretty cool. I like the Long Room. I like the way how it's set up because it has a little balcony area. You can sit and chill there. And, you know, look at some of the pieces. There's a little lounge area in the back. Nice. There's also, you can have a cocktail or wine or beer. So, okay. Yeah.
And will the art be, is it for sale?
Some of the pieces will be on sale, yes. The art will be on sale. It'll be up for a month after the show. So that if they have any events there and people are interested in, you know, buying one of the pieces, they can also purchase one of the pieces.
Okay, so great. So if they are unable to make it at the opening, which is April 4th, once again at the Long Room, they can always attend or visit the Long Room. I know usually it's open on Thursdays because they have like a little tango dance class or whatever, or possibly they can call to see if they can come by and look at the art. So along with the opening, you will also be doing a closing, right?
Yeah.
So the closing should be, was it the 25th?
Yes, the 25th will be the closing, and the time will be the same. Okay. We just confirm that. But okay. The time from 6 to 9, and there will be a closing. And of course, we have a little bit more entertainment there as well.
Awesome. So Victor, I am so excited for you. If you are out there and you're interested, and even if you right now you see this beautiful abstract, you know, a couple of pieces in the back, if you're interested, Victor, how what is your IG? Is I believe it's vic.arts, vic.arts on Instagram.
That's my and,
I'm sorry, repeat that?
Instagram, yes.
Awesome. And also, do you want to leave a telephone number just in case someone is interested? As you said, you know, you do customized pieces as well. So anything is possible. What's another way other than the Instagram for them to contact you?
Well, they can contact me at 704-451-2088. That's my mobile. Or they can also send me an email at victor.callender@yahoo.com.
Awesome. So, Victor, I cannot wait to see what's in store at the art show at the Long Room, 1111 Central Avenue, 6 to 9. Please come out. There's no admission, considering it is an art show. But please come out if something moves you. Please purchase and just take this time to enjoy the scenery. So, yeah. Victor, I want to thank you. But before, is there anything else you want anyone else to know, or the beautiful audience to know about about you, this event, or just anything in general. Here's your time.
I just want to say the entertainment for that night, we'll have a little steel pan player just playing some steel pan music, different genres of music. So come out, have a good time. It's Thursday. You can relax after work, unwind, let your hair down a little bit. Mm-hmm. And, free event is no charge at all, no cover charge. So, come on out.
Awesome. And I do know hors d'oeuvres will be there. However, it is a cash bar. So just want to put that out there. It is a cash bar. So definitely people come out, support, tell a friend to tell a friend to tell another friend. And definitely come and be a part of Vic Arts. So on that note, Victor, I just want to say thank you once again for joining me. Pause, Reset, Unplugged, and thank you for being my first guest. So, people, once again, please come out if you are in the Charlotte region on April 4th, 111 Central Avenue. Did I say it right? 1111 Central Avenue, the Long Room. All right, so be sure to be there. Come out again. I can't stress it enough. You will not be disappointed. So, Victor, once again, I just want to thank you for being my guest.
I want to thank you for inviting me to be your first guest. Oh, my goodness. I can't believe this. I'm excited.
Awesome. So, thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. Have a great day.
This is Beenie, man.
What are you doing?
The girl, them a going well. Good. Them a under we spell. And
does that?
Girl, your body firm like a Range Rover. They take over Bacchanal and the soca. And me a the girl, them music porter. Me hear the song, yeah.
Static.
Ladies, you look good. You don't know. Say a Bacchanal time. Bend over. At your back, girl. That a the position. Jiggle up with the wine. Ladies, you look good. You don't know. Say a Bacchanal time.
The ladies are my favorite thing. Make me want to come kiss you a diamond ring. Call the way you bubble and you make that thing fling. Me a give you my attention, show me how you can bend over. Are you back for your bend, bend over. You look hotter than them, tell you what. You a cause problem, pick it up. 7, 8, 9, 10, come again. Gal, sit up on the head. Hey gal, sit up on the head.
What are you doing? Who does that?
Oh my God. Hey, ladies, you look good. You don't know. Say a Bacchanal time, bend over, at your back, girl, that's the position. Jiggle up with the wine, ladies, wanna look good, wanna don't know. Say a Bacchanal time, bend over, at your back, girl, that's the position. Jiggle up with the wine. The whole bull savanna just take over. Girl, she a wine, I'll pat turn over. All prince and kings and Casanova. Girl, run over them like a bulldozer. Now she a wonder where I gone. Better than typhoon and tree storm. Stand to the pommy body, then cool down. Put on the whipped cream, then the lips on. Things start get low like a steel on. She be with it hard like she eat can. So me say, my girl get a free can. So me get a one call for me phone. And my girlfriend a tell me come home. She's just in a tune. A 24 February, I'm in a this one. And me and him alone. So me sing say, ladies, you look good. You don't know. Say a Bacchanal time. Bend over at your back, girl. That a the position. Jiggle up with the wine. Ladies, wanna look good. Wanna don't know. Say a Bacchanal time. Bend over at your back, girl. That a the position. Jiggle up with the wine.
All right, beautiful people, it is that time again. So I hope that you enjoyed that little session that we had just now with Victor Callender. And if you are in the Charlotte region, you know what to do on April 4th, right? Between the hours of 6 to 9, head over to the Long Room, 1111 Central Avenue, right? So once again, I want to thank you for tuning in to Pause, Reset, Unplugged with me, Natalie. Till next time. Oh, by the way, don't forget to subscribe and share, all right? Also, take time to enjoy your surroundings. Be intentional in wearing your crown, beautiful souls, okay? Be intentional. And whatever you do, be safe doing it. Till next time. Godspeed. Bye.